is my son, JJ Pallo.
Hello.
We'd like to welcome you tonight to an evening of professional wrestling from the Hippodrome Great Yarmouth, brought to you by the star that presents the star in conjunction with Club Video. Tonight's wrestling has three special features. First of all, you have Lady Tag Wrestling. You don't see this on British television. Secondly, we're going to introduce over the period all new international stars. And third, but not last, we have my son and myself to commentate to you, and we have spent our lifetime in a wrestling ring.
Our first bout is between Iron Fist, that's TV's martial arts expert, and he's also the world arm wrestling champion at his weight. He will be against the Masked Axeman, who is a wrestler of somewhat dubious tactics.
Yeah, a lot of people don't like him.
Unfortunately, you can't help taking sides in some of these contests, and I'm pretty sure I know whose side we're going to be on.
Started wrestling in the name of Clive Myers, his real name, but he took up the martial arts and became very famous for it, so he changed his name to Iron Fist. As you probably heard the MC say, he's the world's arm wrestling champion at his weight. The Axeman is a masked wrestler, very unorthodox wrestler, I would say. Uses a lot of strength. He's complaining at the moment about the ring, the belt. He wants him to take it off. We're away from the ring. We're up high, looking down onto the ring, and we can't quite hear what he's saying. You know, Iron Fist never wrestled with a belt on, so I don't know what he's complaining about. But as you can hear from the crowd, they want him to take his mask off. Doing his limbering up. I'm getting a round one.
That's the martial art routine he does.
A marvelous physique, Jack, isn't it?
Incredible.
Well, that's illegal. He's not doing it very hard either. Oh, he missed there. Oh, a very good uppercut. Oh, look, it's him, he blocks it, he's just... He's trying to get that mask out of the mask off. Well, unfortunately, he's in our way, but can't be off.
As soon as he tries to get the mask off, he runs to the ropes.
The crowd shouting, off it, you know. Oh, look at that arm, pulling into one arm, right. Oh, body check. Started chantry. Another side, oh no, he chopped him, blocked him. Another one. Jump over the ropes here and flip him off. Did it, but it wasn't quite enough. He should have had a little more pressure. Back elbow, which is illegal off the side of the ropes. Shouldn't touch a man when he's outside the ring. Referee's given the warning or tell him off about it. Hasn't done much about it. Oh, nice, he pulled him out. I think I've done the same thing yourself. More chops. It's illegal what they're both doing. I mean, they're both really selling out for that. You shouldn't be fighting outside the ring.
Pretty much a nice kick again.
Yeah, super kick.
Please,
will keep going to the ropes. He's trying to weaken that leg, you see, before he gets to tell it off. It's about time he got told off, ref. I don't want to see him get sent out.
I think that's Ironfist's version of a telling off.
Yeah.
Three chops in the face.
Two side chops and a straight finger. Oh, this is one of his chops, I bet. Yes, right on the chest. It's kind of smoky up here, Jack, I must admit that. Oh, he keeps doing that. I don't know why. Well, I do know why. He's trying to weaken his leg, but I mean, he's breaking the rules to do it. No, he didn't slam him. He slammed him over the ropes.
Again illegal.
Again illegal. He can't. He weakened them legs. That's what he's after. He did a side back kick there on the floor, is it? And another one. The referee's doing his... That's the end of round two. Oh, chops. Well, it isn't the end. It should be the end. Put it that way. The referee's having to go at Ironfist now. It's still illegal. Two rights don't make a wrong. What a fit man this Ironfist. Oh, over the top, lovely. Chops. Have a bit of a surprise with bang.
Posting.
Yeah. And another posting. Bang. Oh, suplex. Oh. Beautiful move. Oh, he got to have him there. That's it. First fall to Ironfist. Right.
That shows the power of the man.
Man, yes.
And that's superb lift.
Super lift. Cool.
And oh, he tried to repeat it and he's come unstuck.
He's got his foot on the rock, you see, on the blind side of the referee. Is he submitted? Is he submitted on that? Yes.
I think he did, yeah.
Yeah, the referee never sees his foot, was on the rope. You know, you can't be down there watching, counting the... or asking the man if he wants to submit and see the man. It's very difficult. It's easy for me outside to say the referee can't see it. Listen to the MC now.
Man's been very cagey now.
Yeah.
Looks like he's going to go for that leg again.
No, he's baited it. Oh, see that? See that? Oh, very tight, very tight. Oh, and you see that back kick? And another one. And another one. I think he's getting the better of the X-Man now. Oh no, good for him. And the back elbow onto the chin. Oh, it's got him.
Yeah.
Oh, take your time, take your time, take the time. I'm not taking sides, but like, he's chopping him. Oh, he's doing that jump over again. He's asking how should I do it again. He has. Boom. See, he catches him as he goes down with his arm and it puts his throat onto the rope and it springs up.
Oh, that was definitely a fist.
Yeah. I would think it was. Yeah, he's giving warning. Round five, I think, isn't he? Public warning.
He's not letting him back in, is he?
No, he gets thrown out if he's not careful. And the crowd, shouting their heads out.
again. Oh, he blocks it. Good block. And a chop. Oh, this is what he's noted for. He's dive across.
I dive.
I dive. Oh, look at that dive. Yes.
Right. Give the impact on the land.
Silver.
That's it.
That's it. That's it. Very good.
Oh yes, he's entitled to. If you beat a man, it's tradition in the wrestling business. If a masked wrestler's beaten, he takes his mask off.
Well, I give a million to one. I bet I can guess who you were rooting for. Well, this next fight, ladies and gentlemen, is between Indian Chief Billy White Cloud from the United States of America and Dave Finlay from Belfast. In most fights, you always get needle creep in, and sometimes it brings the better out in men, and sometimes it brings the bad out in them. Well, in this case, I think Billy White Cloud has got his hands full with this boy, Dave Finlay.
This is an international contest over 6 5-minute rounds, 2 falls, 2 submissions, or a knockout to decide the winner. Introducing, on my right, in a red corner,
Dave Finlay from Northern Ireland, who served his time in the army out in Ireland. He is an ex-amateur champion. He's one of the fastest wrestlers in the business today. Indian Chief Billy Whitecar entering the ring. He comes from USA.
Colorado, I believe.
Colorado, that's right. He's got a fantastic physique. He's in Chancery. Edmund. Tackle coming in, bumping over, forearm, He's going to try to do the brute strength and see if he can wear him down. Another tackle, dive over the top. Cross body, very nice. One, two, three, and a first ball for Billy White. I'll now turn you over to the MC. By the way, the referee is Tubby Spicer, an old heavyweight wrestler.
First ball in favour of the Indian wrestler, Billy White.
Lovely black hair that Billy's got, isn't it? There's two things I've got I'm jealous of, his body and his hair. Onto that, you know, the rope throws you off and you run into it. You get double the force.
He's not letting him up off the floor with those kicks, though.
No, he's a little bit anxious. I mean, he's got a lot of, he's got a lot on his plate there. Side head chancery, is he full on? What he's doing on the blind side of the referee, we can see it, the referee can't, he holds on to the Indian's hair. Well, see? Bump. He must have seen that. And the fist. He can't beat him at the wrestling, so he's going to try and roughen him up a bit. I think he's got a lot of chance, a powerful man. And a well-experienced man. Forearm smash. Head butts. No, he's in the doghouse with the referee. You can hear him shouting out, couldn't he?
Mouthful of boots. Oh, mouthful of boot there. Oh, I think Finlay feels like General Custer. He's just too much Indian.
Yeah. Oh, nice double-handed chop. Oh. Well, it was Finlay that started the rough stuff, wasn't it?
And Chief steps back and Finlay steps in.
So you should keep it prepared all the time. Keep your eye on the phone. On that double wrist lock again.
He's bridging, but from the in reverse. He's bridging frontward, not to the reverse.
Put the back hammer on with the bar.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know what that left hand is doing.
Over the knee, over the leg, and trapped with the other leg, and the head trapped into that, and he's even leaving. Oh, he's turning. So powerful, this man. Actually turned then. And the size of those arms.
Throws him out.
Good body tackle. Tackle and
grabbing him by his hair again.
Yeah, he does it a lot. I'm afraid he's losing his little temper a bit there. Another forearm smash.
They must be wearing the chief down, though.
Yeah, that's his plan. See, what happens to a lot of these young boys? They let the crowd dictate. The crowd is, booing him, and he loses his temper. Instead of ignoring the crowd and getting on with the rest of them, he listens to them throwing remarks at him, and it upsets him. See, that doesn't help the wrestling. That starts to work him up. So he's dying. I'm assuming he's got the needle straight away. Tubby Spice is not. Should have jumped in a bit quicker there. He's pulling that air. See, it's silly because he's a super wrestler. They all like this. Right, it does hurt the throat, I must admit. Oh, not as much as that did, I bet. Jump over and kick on the floor. It's illegal. Double handed shot.
Let
it
up.
Do it again. One. And you watch, he jumps and kicks at the same time when he lands. Back head drop. Bonk. Oh, that is nasty.
It's jarred the life out of you, though.
Jarred the life. Goes right down the spine. I hate it.
He's still not letting him up.
No, he's not letting him up. Tubby Spice is having to guide him, but not enough. Still, we can all knock referees. It's a very hard job. Back head drop. He dropped his head, actually, to the floor. Still using that air, you see. Knee drop to the head.
Oh,
they're illegal. That should be stopped. The other man's getting up. He left. As soon as you break a hole, you're not holding the man. You're not allowed to touch him if he's on his feet. Oh. Strangle over there. He's got a good hold. Broken. I'm not sure if that's submission or a bill. I think it's a submission. But he should let go of it. Oh, that's unnecessary, too. I've been showing my finger out there. Now, I think the crowd's getting at him. He's a young... He's not quite used to the crowds having a go at him. That was the equalising for... Well, submission, actually.
He's
silly. He's really got his needle. His stomach upset him. I think it's the crowd more than anything. I often see him like this. I mean, he's wrestled in Yarmouth before, at Yarmouth. Great Yarmouth, the Hippodrome, circus. He's wrestled there before. He's well liked with the crowd. So why he's gone like his stomach's upset him, I'm pretty sure. And what's he doing? Oh, silly boy. Referee. Has the referee seen the towel? He must be back.
He'll be a very irate chief in a minute.
Yeah, he is. Chief, I can see that. Oh, he's got to turn it off by the ref. About time. Billy. Oh! Oh, good bit. Oh, how about it? Oh, what's good for the goose and good for the gander?
He's trying to back away.
He is trying to back away.
Oh!
Wow,
Jackson is straight off the top.
Well, he started to run stuff. Oh, that's really that. I think he also gives White Cloud a public warning then. Charlie Evan up here, the referee, you know, the noisy crowd, is back right here. I've even got a public warning. If you start a public warning, oh, that's nasty.
Deserved, but no.
Oh, well deserved, yeah. I meant nasty from the punishment point.
They look like fists going in
there. They were fists. On the blind side of the referee. There's a little bit of needle crept into here. There's always needling about, but like, there's a little bit more in this one.
It's helping him out the ring.
Yeah.
With his foot.
Sure. Oh, good kick to the stomach, it looked like.
Chubbies, he should have been in the ring when he did it.
Did it, yeah. You shouldn't kick when a man's on the outside of the ring. He's asking for it, isn't he? I mean, he's asking. But he's got the... Oh, he's doing his little dance. Oh, there he goes. Yes, he's got the needle now. Well, he's pulled him outside.
Wallop. Getting some stick round there.
Mm. Oh, head onto the side of the ring. Well, he deserves it.
He was doing his war dance.
Ah, he's been his war dance now. Good forearm smash, knocked him in his tracks. Caught that in the stomach. Oh, he's done it again.
And that's kicking again.
He's definitely lost his temper. Silly, because you can lose your fight. I didn't quite get that, did he? Slam. Oh, good slam. Oh, dear.
He hasn't quite got the experience of Iron Fist.
No. I didn't do a lot of good. Seeing the problem. Oh, back arm drop.
They use that a lot in Germany, don't
they? Yeah. I didn't quite see that. I think it was in the stomach. Punch to the stomach. Tackle. Back elbow. Back elbow. Oh, I missed him. Both moved out of the way and fell over. Drop kick. Oh, miss. Oh.
He's
at about four pop parts there, the knees, the thighs.
And where else?
I don't think he quite caught it. Yes, he's counted out. That was his own fault. The crowd liked it.
It was actually the first and only drop kick of the match.
Yeah.
If he signed it correctly, it would have got it in favour. A bit anxious, but that's what happened. He doesn't feel very happy, does he?
Oh, that was a super fight. Credit to the business is that.
Well, this next bout is a ladies' tag. And for you people that haven't seen tag before, that means you have two people fighting two people. One person in the ring at the time fighting the other opponent. And this is a ladies' tag, so I'll leave my son to you to introduce him to you.
Thank you. We've got Miss Spitfire and Lolita Loren versus Blackfoot Sue and Paula Valdez. Now, a lot of things have been said about lady wrestlers, but they are in fact highly skilled and very professional, as you'll see for yourself.
The next bout of the evening is a ladies' tag team contest. Over 30 minutes duration, two falls, two submissions, or knockouts, to decide the winners. Introducing, on my right, in the red corner, the tag team of the Spitfire and her tag team partner, Lalita Loren. And on my left, their opponents, in the blue corner, the tag team from Canada, Black Fatso.
So much fuss made about lady wrestlers because they have lady sportsmen in virtually everything.
Yeah. And Lalita Loren was born into a wrestling family. Her father was a wrestler, a very good wrestler. You know, ladies going for judo. Funny thing is, more women come to see lady wrestlers than men. Oh, good shot. Good shot.
Looks like we've got another one.
Yeah. Oh, on the lower part of the neck, that is, not on the...
Folding body press?
Good folding body press. She got it now. Yes, I think she's got it, yes. Yeah. Good folding body press.
I think the chops are the...
Yeah, the chops are the...
Second session.
Oh,
posted.
Good posting. Oh, good elbows. There's a little bit of needle crept in here. This is absolutely illegal, by the way.
Put a battery in there.
A lot of fun, but it's illegal. Now behave yourselves. Bit late now, they've done it, you know.
I think we'll leave the rooms for that, I
think. Whoa, yes.
Kicking stamps
over there. Oh, headbutts. Good headbutts. Oh.
She's 2 foot a lot taller after this.
The referee's getting her out now.
Oh! Shouldn't have stepped in there, should he?
All right. I'm
not sure who did that, but I've got my doubt.
Well, yeah. He's giving a public warning for it. I don't think it was quite fair. I think Poland did it mainly. Still, he's the ref. He makes it as he sees it. He's holding the rope so he can't get her out. And Lisa Rain's getting a bit of needle. Look. Thank you. shake hands. I wouldn't if I was you. I think she's experienced. Oh, silly, she did. Never trust a woman. Boom. Powerful girl.
Body check.
Mm. Good body check. Over the top, through the legs. Oh, tender.
Fouling body press.
Oh, good fouling body press, yes. Tricked her.
Spitfire puts the boot in again. In.
Got the right name, isn't she, Spitfire?
I think I know what she said too.
Seconds away.
I always blame the referee. It's amazing.
Oh, she's trying it again.
No,
that was too quick this time.
No, oh, no, missed it. Missed it. Missed it. Sometimes come off and you go straight into the same thing, but not always. I think she's setting her up there for a fist. Good. Yeah, she's put the fist in there. She's tagging now. Arm whip.
Oop. Does love stomping that spit, doesn't she?
Oh! You're a good stomper. Actually, out of the ring, she's quite a nice girl. You wouldn't think butt was milk in her mouth. But in the ring, it's a different world. Wallop!
Oh, headbutt!
Headbutt!
How this?
The lady of the ring, headbutts. It's amazing, there's more referees in the audience than there is outside. You get that at football matches, even at Wimbledon, there's more than referees or judges. Irish whip.
Nice whip.
Another Irish whip. Another one. You've got to go with that, it's your arm is dislocated from the joint.
So, very,
oh, one.
Check.
Huh? Body check. Oh! Try to miss it and went over the top. Done it again.
Mm.
That's an experience showing, you see. You're gonna try it again, surely.
Oh, whip up the ropes and cover.
No. Chris, give him a little kick here, look, for Lita.
Oh, whipping it by her hair.
That's not a wig, is it? Mind you, if I'm just finished, you might need one.
The woman tactics there.
Yeah. Foot up the back and arm stretch back. Nice. Oh, very nice, very nice. And a push off there. And a dive and a miss. Move that away, you gotta be quicker than that. Oh, these girls do take some bumps. Oh, what's this? Oh, nice.
Body
very good.
That's it.
Oh, the crowd loved that. That was super.
Very good move in there.
Very good. Up at the crowd, easy, easy. Who's Lorraine saying something there?
says that women are the weaker sex?
True. Now, who's the next contest? Oh, Johnny Kincaid and John Killer Kowalski. Now, this is a classic heavyweight bout. Two of the greatest heavyweights in Europe.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're joining this bout in the third round. There's been no submissions, no falls, or obviously no knockouts.
You're now seeing the back of Johnny Kowalski, who is fighting Johnny Kincaid. These are two of the best heavyweights in Europe. Hooking in there, Kincaid is the coloured gentleman. He's just hooked in with his right leg. He's trying to take the further arm. He's pushing the arm up now. It's not quite a great vine, but it's, oh, head chance, you know. And he's right onto the knee. Both these men around the 16 stone mark.
They're probably two of the leading contenders for John Quinn's World Heavyweight title.
Oh, without a doubt, without a doubt. Oof, ooh. Forearm smashes.
Good exchange.
Boston, that's Kincaid on top at the moment. He's trying to lift a little job. He wants to try and get a one-legged Boston. No, he can't get it, so he puts a reversed leg lock on. Heavyweights all seem to be slower on film or television, but it's not so. They move just as fast, keeping to the back of the muscle, weakening the muscle on the back of the leg. Leg lock again, and the ankle being twisted the opposite way. In all joints, you always put joints against the joint. That inflicts the most pain. He's got a wrist lock there, or no he hasn't. He attempted wrist lock. Knee drop. He's worked on that knee for three rounds. He's still working on it. Leg dive. Onto the knee again, pop, and look round. He differed from the other fight, where he kept his knees in. This boy's looking in, and locking the leg between his own legs. And if you notice, he pushes the elbow of his left arm into the groin, which is legal, quite legal. And he's putting full weight of the leg. See how the ankle is twisted opposite? Oh no, he's got. No, he can't.
He's trying a face bar, isn't he?
Yeah, he's trying a face bar, but it's a bit awkward. Someone's got your leg at an angle. There? Now he's twisting it back the other way, using his head as a lever. Leaving himself open for a spin there, though. Leaving himself wide open. Onto the ring is detraction, or try to detract the man, take him off his centre foot.
That's
the spin, left himself open for it. Now he's back in again. Jarring the knee downwards. What a lot of people don't realise that wrestling is one of the oldest sports ever, one of the first Olympic sports there ever was.
might have another kick in the hand.
Still got the leg.
He's still sticking to the ankle.
You can always tell what a fight is like by the reaction of the crowd. They're either screaming or they're very quiet. In this case, they're rather quiet. Appreciation on the end of the round. That was the end of round three. That's Johnny Kowalski on the floor. He'd been wrestling about 15 years as a professional. Very powerful man.
Seconds away.
Has a good reputation. Sort themselves out, looking at each other, weighing each other up. Oof. Kicks the stomach, kicks the knee. Oh, knee jump. Another one.
One's connected more on the head, another one's on the arm.
Oh, yeah. Do the crowd appreciate this? Oh, good throw. We use the rope to throw them, get the formation. Throw them off. The front edge arms, you know, yeah.
Back elbow. Oh.
They evenly match these two.
Oh, he blocked the throw.
Yeah.
Oh, knee drop. He's not, no, head drop. Oh, lovely. He went in for a knee, he went for a knee drop. And Kincaid head scissors him.
Dived across him. No, he got off of it. And Kincaid landed on the referee. Yeah. Cross buttock, and he got him. He run him off. As he came off the rope, cross him, cross buttock. Enjoying this match. That's Johnny Kincaid.
He started off about 12 stone.
Yeah, I wrestled him a few years ago, 10 years ago, and he was, say, about 12 stone. Now he's way over the 16 mark. Running at round five. I know he's got hard head.
Most of the colour boys have, haven't they?
Yeah. Oof. And an elbow to the side of the face. Wait. Oh.
Good forearm.
Good forearm. Oof. Caught him with a second one right, didn't it?
That was illegal.
A bit over anxious. But we all do this, you know. Arm lever there, he's pressing the hard part of the hand into the nose. That's right.
Oh, nice move, nice, yes. Forward, oh, nice.
Forward press there.
Kowalski, he thought he was coming off the load the first time. Second one bounce.
Very appreciated by the crowd, you see. In this fight, even though they elbow it. There's a final round coming up. Yeah. Told him about him crutch. I don't think he'll hold him. No. Gonna wear a man down a bit more than that to hold him down. That looked like an headbutt to the stomach.
nasty. Bell, what a super contest. Both men focused, getting the fall, making it a draw.
It's a relief on their faces after that bounce.
What a super match. Look at that, shaking hands on the floor, that is super.
In this next fight, both my son and I are both involved. So, obviously, we couldn't do the commentary. So what we did, we recorded it and done the commentary afterwards. I think you're going to enjoy this.
On my left, in the red corner, Steve Kelly. And ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner, the official middleweight wrestling champion of the world, the magnificent Adrian Street. And on my left, in the blue corner, at the tag team, I've had the pleasure to introduce many times before, ladies and gentlemen, the tag team of Jackie, Mr. Timmy Pro, and Jackie, Timmy Pro Jr., wrestling's most famous friend.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's Adrian Street there, warming up. This is the first session. And this is the thing that annoys a lot of wrestlers. Adrian Street doesn't come into here. He keeps mucking about and showing his body off. He does this to give you the needle, and I'm sure it does give you the needle. You expect a man to come out and wrestle you, but he doesn't. He's moving about. If you go into him, you come unstuck, you see. You probably notice he's wearing a beard at this moment. I understand that he's off shortly to Iceland to make a film. That's all I can tell you at this time. Well, he's got a... No, he's not a scissors. This is something that I cannot stand. He holds you in a throat hold, then kisses you. I think my son likes it. In fact, I know he doesn't like it. Super top kick, Jack. Super top kick. Slap round the face. Holding the hair, which is not legal. Back elbow there. Knocks Steve Kelly out. Out of the ring, by the way. Nice row. Oh. Another slap to the face. He's a not all good elbow, a good elbow. And another one. Oh, he didn't quite catch him there. He got him with that one, though. Hey, Adrian Street's got out the ring. Steve Kelly's coming in. Oh, a beautiful back kick. Good back, and a throw. Oh, still in. Up the knee. Turning the toe in. Pressing the knee down so it's against the joint. Yes, I tagged there. It's my time now. I've tagged, my son goes out and I have to come in. Oh, nice. Edo, arm over there. See where you're watching yourself fight. See the mistakes you made. Adrian Street has now got my ribbon off. Well, my son's ribbon, I realise now. It's my son's ribbon, and he's got it round my throat. And the referee is sending my son out, which he's quite entitled to do. But I don't think he realises that Adrian Street has got a ribbon in his hand. Yes, you see, he's got it round my throat. I'm going over the face there. The referee still hasn't seen it because I'm away from him, I'm away. Pop, oh, good elbow. Oh, got out. Leg dive onto the knee. He's holding the ropes.
I'll pull him in here. The referee said, pull him in. I did. You either pull him in or let go. Jackie's in now. Arm lever, yeah. Back arm. Oh, that was a fist. But on the blind side of the referee. Kick in the back. Drop to the knee. And another drop chop. And another drop chop. Nuts. Headbutt. Right comes Street. Barton's tagged and he's allowed in. I think he's still got, yes, he's got that ribbon round Jackie's throat. Kicking him on the back. I can't see why the referee hasn't seen the ribbon. I'm telling him, you hear me, I'm shouting at him. He's got a ribbon round his throat. The referee's sending me out, which he's quite entitled to do, but he should have realised there's something wrong, so I'm telling him. Now, Steve Kelly's kicking him from the outside. These kicks are quite legal, as long as you're holding the man's leg. This is not legal, you can't see it, but I believe... Yeah, that's it. He put his leg on the rope and dropped on it. It's a legal hold. Quite legal hold. He shouldn't have got that, he should have let him get up. He's broken the hold. Is the ropes? Ooh, kick to the knee, and another drop to the knee, and a kick to the knee. We're working on Jackie's knee. What's he doing? So he's trying to put. Yeah, he's going to put it on the rope. Yeah, we see, and Street goes up onto the post and drop down for the knee. Again, she's on the rope, followed and dropped across it. That is illegal. The referee hasn't taken any notice. I don't know why. They should let him get up there. He didn't, you see. The referee should have stepped in there. Oh, Boston. Oh, he's got a one-legged Boston, his head, his foot on the back of his head. Well, that's the first submission there. And I'll turn you over to the MC. You probably hear the crowd are saying a lot of rather rubbish. That means they don't like the way the tactics that they use. Good fist for me. A good punch. Adrian there reflecting his muscles. The reason they're saying they're like rubbish, not because of on the tactics they're doing. I mean, the tactics is rubbish. I'm in. No, I shouldn't be in. Put it that way. I'm in, but I shouldn't be. Person that was, that's it. Oh, back on the Jackie's leg again. Tagged, he should really break the hold and let him up before he takes over. Bad on the referee's part. Jackie's calling out the referee. Both men should break the hold. He shouldn't allow it to bring him in. The referee's at fault badly there. And he said again he's at fault, he should have been up on his feet. Ooh, he's thrown him against the rope so that he hit the back of his leg on the rope. Look, see, he's done it again. Hit him on the chest. Steve Kelly's in again. coach again. Good ball. That's what we mean by a chess game. You get the vote overconfident, he makes that one mistake. He does it too many times to you, and he makes a mistake, and that's the mistake he made. Illegal, but I got away with it. Yeah, you can only take so much before you lose your temper. Good elbow there. Slam, and... oh! That landed right on his buttock. Very strange looking at yourself. Elbow. You keep sticking the fist in if you look carefully. That's nice. You see, we set him up for this. That's what I mean by playing chess. Each move, you see, I set him up for that. I took the elbows on the chin to make sure that he gets overconfident.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the tag match. We certainly enjoyed watching it, which was more than we did at the time while we were doing it, getting all that stick. Well, that's the end of this first tape, and I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we've enjoyed commentating on it.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.